Okay, interesting topic today. It has to do with the Stargate found in the desert of Iraq. What is it and what does it do, but most importantly, how does it work? Of course, first a quick history lesson of its origins. In the antediluvian era before the flood event, sometime before 75,000 years ago, there was an enigmatic figure known as Malik. He was the guardian of the astral realm, a place described by Thoth in the Emerald Tablets as the gateway into Amenti, where he and the other sages of his era would transcend into death and return to the same lifetime. Thoth goes on to record that him and the Ascended Masters did this over 1,000 times until one day they were unable to return and had lost the power to traverse into Amenti. The Emerald Tablets were the last of the Ascended Masters or Sages' accounts just before he died as well. This tale is a reference to one of the nine sages whom Thoth described as the dweller or guardian of the gateway into the astral realm. The deciphered history continues as this, that Malik had a gateway that led into the astral realm. The astral realm was created to be like a waypoint between life and death. When one of their kind would die, they would slip into an alternate state of suspended life by being pulled into the astral realm, where they could gather themselves and apply their magic to heal themselves and return to life, elongating their life spans to be that of 985 years or more by some accounts. There was an entire civilization of these people that lived somewhere in the range of about 250 million years ago to about 158 million years ago. That is around when the golden age of their society began to crumble into catastrophe after catastrophe, never really able to pull themselves back to the advanced society they once were, which ended about 75,000 years ago. Malik was a guardian of this realm, and he had a physical gateway he used to cross into this realm. That is what this Stargate is. It's the gateway into the astral realm. Now, many today don't believe in real magic or understand it. Magic is an advanced form of geological and quantum physics. It combines the knowledge of geological weather events with the quantum levels of its functionality and adapts it to a way that can be used by an individual. They can alter weather patterns, natural disasters, influence plant growth, change and adapt other animals' sensory traits, even alter their own aging process, just to name a few possibilities they have been known for. This gateway, though it may seem to be arcane lore of a culture that many perceive to be unevolved and archaic, is actually quite an advanced piece of hardware and stands as a testament to that claim. The notches and symbols tap into the quantum particle field and reform those particles to create an Einstein-Rosenberg bridge. The key to using the gateway lies in an artifact known as the Peruvian Sunstone. The Sunstone holds the key to bridging the way to the destination point within the gateway. Now, something I do not know is whether the ancient sages built the gateway and the portal leading to the astral realm, or whether the portal has always been here and they just found a way to tap into that portal. There is evidence that suggests both possibilities. On one hand, to suggest that they tapped into a portal that already existed leads to there being other gateways to other dimensions, and that this is just one of nine gateways. On the other hand, there are also ancient texts and spells that can create entire other dimensions and gateways and portals that can link those dimensions to this one. In fact, when Malik had descended into evil and became the antediluvian character known as the Demiurge, when he was defeated, they say the Ascended Sages cast him into an alternate pocket dimension called the Forbidden Realm they created, and then sealed him inside forever. For the historical buffs who want more content and references to this, only need to search under the keyword antediluvian lore, and you'll find many research topics on this era. So to get the Stargate to work, you need the key to use it, and you would have to take it back to its place of origin for it to work, and that won't happen because the entrance to the astral realm was located to be used between two of the nine mountain volcanoes that make up the Ring of Fire, and they're at the bottom of the Pacific now. Plus, you would have to find the Peruvian Sunstone, the amulet used to open the gateway. There is a possible way though. If you knew the exact energy levels the gateway emitted to connect to the astral dimension and triangulated the exact position through the resonance patterns current field variance within the wormhole that goes through the Devil's Seas off the coast of Japan and the Bermuda Triangle off the coast of Florida that make this portal possible and geometrically synchronize it to the positions the gateway is already set to tap into that allows for the portal to lock onto it, then it might work. You see, much time has gone by since the gateway was made and the atmospheric conditions and energy levels have changed since then. It needs to be recalibrated to find the right signature patterns in order to be positioned correctly for it to work. There are also warnings that should be heeded, recent past events that says this portal is very much still active and there is a hazard to note of when within the region of the Pacific Seas and Caribbean coastal area. Many disappearances have been attributed to these regions that seem to be triggered by the combination of using radio wave transmissions and magnetic compasses. These may be attributed to the effects of the wormhole and the combination of a certain radio wave frequency and the magnetic compass may possibly react to the unstable particles causing a rift to open where people and even entire ships and planes have fallen into the vortex of the wormhole. Though it may be possible that these people are still alive since time does appear differently in these wormholes. Thousands of years here could go by, but to them it may have been only minutes or even seconds. So if there are any corporate or political powers that may intend to do research on this subject, it could easily be covered by an inquiry to ascertain the possibilities of a rescue operation for those who have gone missing. Just throwing that out there for some reason or another. Thank you.